Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I hope you all are doing great. So last time in our series of Hindu Indian wedding, we took you to the mehndi ceremony, and now let's go to the next ceremony. I will explain you what is the haldi ceremony later on, but let's see what we did on that day. So that day early morning we woke up and everybody took a bath and got ready. And then me and my youngest sister, we both were preparing some food and some sweets. Here we are preparing some fried food item which needs to be given at the time of puja, and these are called pakoda. And pakoda is here made up of dal, basically pulses, and the other side you can see some tomato paste and some masala ingredients are cooking for some paneer dish. So here we are deep frying the pulses paste to make a pulses pakoda, and here we are preparing some paneer, basically cottage cheese dish curry with some peas. So all this food will be served to the god as well as to the priest. After preparing both of them, we prepared some roti, Indian bread. So here we can see the priest has arrived and he was preparing for the rituals. He was setting up all the required items for the puja ritual. Here you can see my sister, the bride, also helping the pandit preparing all the items required. So they are making some traditional items required for this whole event. You can see some rice, some turmeric, some designs made from the flour and turmeric, and tons of various Hindu ritual items. The puja is gonna start here after this. This is the turmeric paste which needs to be applied on the bride. These are some rice and some pulses, some mango leaves, some sweets and the pakoras which we prepared in the morning. Some other items like curd, flour, etc.
महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती देवता भिनवा श्री सती लक्ष्मी शरदा महराती माखी कथांडू कृष्णव्याम्बा महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती देवता ब्रह्मा सर्व मंगल मांगल्ये शुभे सर्वा शांति शरणे तंबिके गौरी नारायणी नमस्ते सुनाथ
So what you heard was the priest chanting all the ritualistic shlokas and everything which they chant during the puja. And now the haldi ceremony is starting. So the youngest girl in the family, she starts the haldi ceremony first. So let's talk about haldi ceremony. What is a haldi ceremony? A haldi ceremony is the one in which a paste of haldi is applied to the bride and the groom before the wedding, and this ceremony is held at both the bride and the groom's place on the morning of the wedding day. And in few areas of India, usually the ceremony is also held a day before the wedding. So basically you can do it a day before the wedding or on the same day as the wedding. If the wedding is an evening event, you can do the haldi ceremony in the morning. It is known by different names in different regions of India. Like some people call this haldi as uptan or mandha or telban. So we are from Uttarakhand, and in Uttarakhand we call it the ban basically. And you can see all the family members, sisters, siblings, parents, cousins, grandparents, everybody coming one by one and doing this ritual. My mom is applying haldi on my sister. Traditionally, people make a paste using haldi and different ingredients according to their individual family customs. While some mix the haldi with the sandalwood powder and milk, and others mix it with rose water, this paste is then applied on the bride and the groom's face, neck, hand, feet by their near and dear ones. In many customs, the bride and the groom also apply a small portion of this sacred paste to their unmarried friends and siblings. It is said, or maybe you can say that it's a belief that whoever gets touched by this paste will soon find a good-looking partner. So yeah, in the end of this ceremony, people play with the haldi quite much and apply it to their friends, cousins, siblings who are unmarried. It's quite fun. So here is a garland made up of mango leaves tied on the door of the house as a ritual. Om Jaya Jaya Jaya. So as per the Indian beliefs, most people believe that the reason for applying mehndi is to ward off evil spirits from affecting the bride and the groom. This is why the bride and the groom are usually not allowed to leave their home after this haldi ceremony until their wedding day. And in some traditions, they are also tied to a sacred red thread or given some small amulets and other items for protection against evil eyes. So here aarti is going on, and one by one everybody is coming and doing the aarti for the bride. The yellow color of turmeric is considered very auspicious in Indian tradition. And this is why in many cultures the bride and groom wear yellow clothes on their wedding day as well. In the olden days, when cosmetic beauty treatments and parlors were not available, Indians had their own natural beauty secrets to ensure that the couple looked radiant and wonderful on their wedding day. And haldi is known to have properties that leave the skin fair and glowing. Since turmeric or haldi is known for its medicinal properties as well as being antiseptic, an application of this ingredient before marriage would also ensure that the bride and groom are blessed with blemish-free skin and they look their best on their wedding day. And it also protects them against any cuts, bruises or ailments before the wedding. Haldi or turmeric holds such an important place in Indian traditions because it also purifies and cleanses the body. So you can say that apart from its property of beautification, cleansing and detoxification, turmeric is also known to alleviate some of the nervousness that the bride and the groom might be feeling before their big day. So it is a good way to relieve the wedding day anxiety and jitters. And turmeric is also known to boost immunity and also helps to soothe an upset stomach. So you see, I have listed out so many beneficial properties of this specific ritual. So it's, you can say that in Hindu rituals, everything which is done have some meaning and have some not only religious sentiments but also some scientific advantage and benefits. So here all the senior ladies of the house, they are just doing some ritual of blessing the girl before her marriage day. So basically, according to the ancient text, there is a significance for every ritual that forms a part of Indian wedding, including this haldi ceremony. All these ladies of the house, like my aunt, mother, myself, my grandmothers were there, both paternal and maternal side. All these ladies who were involved in this ritual or the ones who apply haldi or turmeric to the girl showers the bride-to-be and the groom-to-be with lots of happiness and togetherness. All the ladies, while applying the paste or doing any kind of rituals which you can see here, basically bless them for a happy married life. So here the ritual is on its final leg. My brother is sitting with the bride-to-be. Here, in this part, the brother needs to sit with the sister, basically the bride-to-be, and some other small rituals are done here. So the puja is almost finished on this part. Look at this.
Yeah, elephants.
Let's see.
This is nice. This is the elephant.
Who made this?
Yeah, Raksha made this.
Is this baby elephant Chosaku?
Yeah, something like that, huh?
What about this design?
So nice. This is a cherry blossom.
And what is this? Oh, wife's name.
Raksha. Yeah.
Cherry blossom.
Yeah. You see the petals are heart shaped and there are 5 petals. Hello everybody, today was the day for Haldi. So we were doing all the ceremonies for 3-4 hours and now everything is finished. Yeah, so we're gonna wait for the marriage function, which is gonna happen tomorrow. Yeah. Today something around 10 relatives were coming. And tomorrow I think much more is gonna have come, and also some groom side family is also gonna come, so it's gonna be a big event. So let's see what happens tomorrow.
This marks to the end of the video. I hope you all enjoyed. This was the third day of our wedding program and the last day is the wedding day. I hope you will all love the final day also. So if you liked our video, please don't forget to like and comment. Also subscribe our channel. Let's meet you in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and thanks for watching. Bye bye.